today I want to show you the most brilliant alternative to all of those standard and time-consuming computer renders. I personally call this approach the most revolutionary 3D approach to the interior design process. You're gonna love it too, I promise, because this is the fastest, most flexible, most creative, and of course the most innovative 3D technique you can implement in your own creative workflow literally after finishing watching this video. And it doesn't matter whether you work for your design clients or whether you're currently doing your home renovation project, because this technique is a beginner-friendly technique. That means that you don't need any special drawing talent, you don't need any art or design degree. The only tools you'll need are your iPad. It doesn't matter which one, by the way, the only thing you're gonna need on your iPad is the Procreate app, that's all. And then AI, well, ChatGPT to be more precise, because in this video you'll also see how you can integrate AI into your own creative work in the most seamless way possible. Because I don't know about you, but I've always hated on computer renders. Wow, even during my interior design studies, that was one of my huge disappointments ever, because it is my second degree and I'd been dreaming about it for over a decade, because first I got my degree in journalism and only after that I took that leap to follow my childhood dream, so to speak. And then imagine my disappointment when I was told to use that Vectorworks program, which basically made my designs to look super average and my creativity was left out because my entire time was dedicated to learning that software. That was a huge nightmare. Well, basically this is now one of my main reasons why I do what I do today. I draw and design for a living. I coach creatives just like you to use their iPad design and drawing skills in their creative works, and I also work with commercial clients. So it's gonna be so much fun today. You're gonna love this approach, I promise. And before jumping right into the design process, I want to show you a few more examples. You can still use those flood computer renders, but you can liven them up and then you can use AI for that final render. Well, basically you can forget about all of those also expensive renders like 3D Max and others, because look, so precise, right? The example number one, the example number two, same story. First of all, I imported the before picture, the before photo into the Procreate app, and we're going to be working with that shortly. Then I played around with different ideas, rugs, sofas and all of these things, and then the final render done with AI. One more example, the before, the iPad design phase and the final render. Incredible, right? Less than freaking 30 minutes. Wow. Okay, all right, let's get started. I prepared this example for you. So basically, the first step is to import that picture, as I mentioned, right? And after that, look, we are getting rid of all of those things we don't need. So I'm going to get rid of all of these things and show you how you can do it on your own. I'm going to enable the assisted drawing feature, and in order to be able to do that, I first created a one-point perspective. And then before diving into the color section, I draw my auxiliary lines to know where my back wall will actually end, because obviously right now the space is cluttered and I can't really imagine where and how to start. Now my auxiliary lines are here, and then I usually create a new layer right below those lines, and using the selection tool I select the area which I need to get rid of. Then I'm finding a neutral shade of the background color, and here we go. And the next step is to add a few shadows and all of these things like this, so that it looks more or less three-dimensional. Here the most important thing is to not overanalyze anything. The goal of this step is to clear up this space like this, because the next step will be so much fun. The next step is to navigate to AI and ask it to create a few perspectives. By the way, before diving into the next part of our today's video, I wrote an entire guide on how you can implement iPad design and drawing in your own creative workflow together with AI. It is completely free, and that guide can be found right below this video in the description. And now we're going to move on to the stage with the AI render. The thing is that AI is also brilliant for creating necessary perspectives. Let's say we have our table, right, that we found on the internet and we want to try it out. But the thing is that the perspective isn't quite right. And this is how you can ask ChatGPT to create the exact perspective you need. The idea was to first create the dining room, the dining table and the dining chairs placement. So I did that, but the perspective was wrong. Then I asked ChatGPT to redo it a little bit, and that was the result. But I wasn't done yet, because then I decided to ask it to create a few more designs, but with different chairs here and here. And then look, I got rid of the background and imported those chair and table options into my Procreate app, so that first of all I can position them according to the perspective, obviously, because on the AI render those compositions were a little bit too big and they were a little bit too far from the window, and on my render I wanted them to have closer to the window. This is how I decided to go with this one instead of this one, because these chairs were a little bit too dark for me. And after that I started the experimentation phase on my iPad, because you might be thinking right now, okay, cool, we already have our AI render here, like why bother, you know, designing on our iPad? Not that simple, because it all comes down to the details, right? Because when we talk about creative work, it's not about all of those general colors. It's all about details. It's all about those finishing touches. And of course, we need that flexibility to play around with them. Maybe to sketch something, maybe to move this or that thing a little bit to the right or a little bit to the left, right? Or maybe we want to, I don't know, to play around with some other positions of this or that decor element without needing to write all of those prompts and then being frustrated about why it didn't turn out exactly how we wanted it to be, right? And in order to avoid all that, why don't you simply switch to your iPad and give you that flexibility you've been searching for? This is how you can play around with different racks. Yes, you can even import your racks and position them in 3D. For that, I usually use the distort feature, see? Tick, tick. Then, when I was super happy with my rack, I moved on to the light fixtures. And the same story. Here I can play around with the position of that light fixture. Here, or maybe there, or maybe there. Or maybe I can find a lamp which has something, I don't know, something here. Just an example, okay? And then I open AI or open Google and search for that lamp, because I want to have more light bulbs or something like that. So I'm going to undo my previous actions and leave everything as it was before. And then my lamp was done, and then I imported that artwork. And that artwork, mind you, was a brilliant solution for my accidental idea. Basically, when you find something truly inspiring for your interior, let's say something in a magazine, or maybe you took a picture when you were traveling but the quality isn't best for your render, you can ask AI to generate that exact image but for your visualization. This is how I created this particular artwork. I took a picture, the quality wasn't really great, and then I asked ChatGPT to create that frontal perspective so that I can use it in my render. Ta-da! Perfect, isn't it? And then a few more details like the fruit bowl and the final lamp. Obviously, you can play around with different lamps. As you can see, all of these elements, they have different layers. At the end of the day, all of these layers will allow you that flexibility you need in your project. And look, once you're done with your final design, after all of the experimentations, look, you can even, let's say, you want to try black on your back wall. You're going to want to click select, create a new layer, and the next step is to do this. Wow, this actually looks cool. I love it! See, this is how you come up with cool ideas during the design process. It wouldn't be the same had I used ChatGPT, right? But now, cool, I like black. What about checking, I don't know, dark beige or brown or something like that? Nah, black was cool, right? And this is how the design process happens. Honestly, I was so incredibly happy when I discovered this approach. It is my own signature design approach, which I'm making available to you. All of these ideas, they come to me when I work in my commercial projects, when I do something for my home arena. This approach will definitely be used for my living room makeover, because I have a living room. It's huge, but I don't use it. I don't watch TV. My sofa isn't being used because when I have friends come over, we have the dining room area was super comfortable, and you can literally sleep in those chairs. This is why I decided to sell everything and turn my living room into an art studio, so to speak. And already took a few pictures on Instagram, Pinterest, and all of these things, but now I want everything come together. Of course, I'll be using AI and my iPad drawing skills, because even though I have a picture of my living room, I have a picture of that idea, let's say of this or that shelf, but now it needs to come together, right? Because I don't really have time to draw everything from scratch. So I'm going to ask ChatGPT to create a perspective for that corner. Then I'm going to use the iPad to like merge everything together, and then for the final render I'm going to use again ChatGPT, and this is the result of that particular design that we were currently doing. Wow, isn't that precise? Okay, forget about the black wall, but basically the same, right? The freaking same, because what I've been noticing is that when you don't use such things like the iPad, well, basically that's all you can use before the AR render, there will be inaccuracies. Like, I don't know, a wall will be a little bit weird, or some of the older elements will reappear, so to speak. With your digital design and drawing skills, you'll be able to avoid all that, to save time on all of those changes and revisions, because obviously you would need to ask ChatGPT to adjust this or that perspective. And at the end of the day, again, frustration, not better compared to a computer render, right? Here, all is under your control. You are enjoying the creative process. You can even draw something over it, right? Ta-da, but I really loved that black wall. Love it. So I want to ask ChatGPT to create the exact same render, but now with a black wall. And since you're here, I wanted to show you a few more examples. In fact, one of my all-time favorite examples. First, the before picture, the in-between design process, and the final AI render. And mind you, it was like so precise. Look, first things first, obviously the before picture. And then step by step, again, I was trying out colors, different kitchen options, even the rug. This one is actually part of one of my tutorials for my academy. Yes, I also run the largest iPad design and drawing academy, because these skills, these tools, they're so freaking brilliant. Wow, I wish I had that during my interior design studies almost 10 years ago. But now you're watching this video, you're on the winning side already, right? You try out your ideas, let's say you'd like to try out a few more lamps like this. You do that without any problems, and then based on your final design, you create a final render in literally seconds. So, as I said at the beginning of this video, the entire process takes you max 30 minutes. A few more examples. Oh yeah, I have a lot of examples for you when it comes to quick designs. This one, but I already showed it to you at the beginning of this lesson, right? Same story. Computer model, quick tests. Let's say I wasn't sure which closet I wanted to have here. So I simply created that layer, and then I started experimenting and decided to go with this one. Or with the bed. In this case, I was lucky enough to have this exact bed on the website of that brand, so I didn't need to create a render. But in case you do need to do so, ChatGPT is going to help you with that. Remember the example with my dining chairs. And then step by step, I started playing around with more and more and more ideas. And as the result, we have this render. Wow. Wow. I love it. I feel like a child in a candy store with these tools. My main struggles in the past, you know, before all of those iPad and AI things, I've been a creative for over 10 years. Those struggles were mainly no ideas where and how to start, criticizing myself for not being able to draw a landscape in the most realistic way, or an interior in the most realistic way, and of course, oh, wasted time, energy, and also money on all of those computer renders. Three main struggles. And right now, my mission is to make you avoid those. Those are not true. There are solutions. You can avoid that. You can make your creativity thrive when you have the tools. And I'm here to give you those tools.